Given the fact that blood collected expires within 35 days, there is always a continuous demand for blood in the hospitals. According to the executive director of the Uganda Blood Transfusion Services, Dorothy Cheyune, 50% of the blood collected is used by anemic children, 25% by expectant mothers, while the rest goes to the accident victims. To stem the anticipated blood shortage in the country, officials from the Uganda Blood Transfusion Services have launched a massive countrywide campaign to collect blood. The target is to collect at least 5,000 units of blood.
So partnering with the UPTS, the Blood Bank, to give back to community. To give back to community by donating blood, by organizing blood drives across the country, these month-long blood drives, which we are going to collect 5,000 units of blood. And as you are aware, most of our blood donations are from students in schools. Schools are going to have holidays. So this has happened at the right time. When you collect blood during this month, that means you shall have enough stocks of blood to be able to give those patients in need, those mothers.
During this time of the school holidays, shortage is anticipated in the hospitals, simply because the school-going children, who are the main donors, would be at home. Uganda Blood Transfusion Services need to collect 450,000 units of blood annually, but unfortunately, they only managed to collect 330,000 units last year, thus registering a huge shortfall of blood. They have rallied all concerned members of the public to donate blood.
Collect at least 1% of their population. So if we have a population of 45 million Ugandans, then we need to collect the 1% is 410,000 units of blood per year. But when we look back, when we analyzed, we thought that if we collected 350,000 units of blood, this would be sufficient to cover our hospital blood needs. But the challenge, you cannot, like this year, we only managed to collect 330,000 units of blood, so leaving a shortfall of about 5%.
The Indian High Commissioner to Uganda explained that they have decided to donate blood to save the lives of mothers, children and those involved in accidents who may need blood. This comes at a time when the Indian community is celebrating their 77th anniversary of their country's independence.
7th Independence Day of India, and on this solemn occasion, our pleasure is multifold because High Commission has joined hand with the Indian Association, Indian Women Association and UBTS. We have the director Dorothy here, and coming all of us together to organize blood donation camp, and the Indian Association is organizing it in multiple places in the city, and then also in various other cities of the country, and this drive will continue for a month.
COVID vaccines also were given by the Indian government, and today you have seen the live example. The first donor of this drive was His Excellency the High Commissioner. So itself the message that the both countries' relations are very strong, and we look forward for more opportunity.
Story by Jalit Namuwaya for the news.